What's good, guys? It's your boy, Baby Boy, back at it again with another one. Today, I wanted to go over the top five shoes everyone needs in their rotation. Before I do that, as always, we're gonna go over that fit check. What I got on head today is a Haven Court New York Yankees hat. As you can see, there's the little hint of the star running around the New York logo. I added the iron-on patch to the bill of the hat, and I think that gives it a nice touch. Of course, gray underbrim, very clean hat. Shout out to Keezy, shout out to Haven Court as well. I'm wearing a, it's kind of like an OG color of the Patagonia Cinchilla. I have on an ASOS oversized sweatpants. They have the toggles on the ankles as well. That's really nice for cinching in the fit, giving it a good like Yeezy Season 3 look. And then of course, I do have the Yeezy 500 Salts on feet. This is a super casual fit. I'm not really going outside today because it's been snowing like crazy, but feel free to like and subscribe on this video. It would definitely really help me out as far as the algorithm goes. Comment below, what do you think of my rotation? Do you have all five of these or am I tweaking? Let me know what you guys think. Also, feel free to follow me on Instagram if you aren't already. Like I said, I will not buy another pair of shoes until I hit 1,000 followers on Instagram. That's gonna be tough for me because I have been buying a pair of shoes for every month for a very long time. But I think it's good to stop here and try to build with you guys. I'm gonna be posting different fit picks there. I'll let you guys know when I have videos up on there. I'm probably gonna even dive into reels at some point, but please give me a follow there because then I'll be able to buy a pair of shoes. If not, it's all good. Rolling into the five sneakers everyone needs in their rotation. We're starting off with the white sneaker. So the all white sneaker is something that is a staple in anyone's closet, really. It's just a good way to put a fit together no matter what you're wearing. It's an all white sneaker. It's very clean. It makes you come looking a lot more presentable than, you know, a dirty shoe. To that point, the all white sneaker needs to be all white. All right. It needs to be relatively clean. I don't think you have to throw out a pair of all white Air Force Ones after you wear them five times. Not what I'm saying, but don't come with them super beat like you just came from Lollapalooza or Coachella. That's not what we're looking for in the all-white sneaker. These need to be a bit more presentable. You need to be able to throw these on. This is kind of like this is something I wear on like a date night, the all-white shoe. It looks very clean. It makes you look presentable. The cool thing about all-white shoes also is that they are always available, almost always available. Any time of the year, you can get an Air Force One. Any time of year, you can get a Stan Smith. Those are two that I think are iconic all-white sneakers. I really like the Reebok Club C as well. The all-white sneakers that I'm rocking these days are going to be I'm rocking the Converse Rocket collaboration. I believe this is the Converse Court. I'll have to do a check on what model this was. But these were really nice because the translucent, like, ice blue sole on the bottom. I thought that was a really nice hit. And then with the, of course, the orange Rocket dot on the medial side, but these aren't all the way clean, and I still think that they're a good look. This is one of my all-white shoes. And then on the other end of the spectrum, we do have more of a beater. This is an Adidas from like 2006. I like it because it looks a bit more vintage, but I'm not going to let it get any more beat than it already is. You know, if it's more beat than this, it's time to get a new all-white pair. I don't think you have to go for the Air Force One. I don't think you have to go for Stan Smith or the Reebok, as I mentioned. I think an all-white shoe is essential, though. It can have little hits of color. Little pops of color on there, I think, do look good. An all-white shoe, definitely a must for anyone's sneaker rotation. Number two, we're talking about a loud sneaker. So this probably makes up the majority of my collection. This is a shoe with either a ton of color on it. It's got a strange design. It's just loud. It's a head turner. People look at it and they're like, whoa, what is this kid rocking? I really like the loud sneaker because it really shows off a lot of personality. I love sneakers and I collect sneakers because they are an extension of my personality. It's a way of showing off who I am. So a lot of my shoes are very loud. I didn't grab the craziest shoes I have, but for example, I've got the Nike SB Blazer. This one came out in, why do I always gotta do this every video? 09. It looks like a watermelon. And I do think the colorway is pretty sick. These are SBs. I've skated them before. Super loud. They're gonna turn heads when you wear them. As well as, this is probably the most popular shoe right now as this category, as like the loud shoe. The Jordan 1. I mean, the design of it, the different colorways that are available. This shoe is gonna turn heads. This is definitely a loud shoe and people are gonna know what you're rocking. But as far as loud shoes go, they really show off who you are. They show off what you're into. And within streetwear, the loud shoe has just been topping the charts recently. I mean, everyone's rocking these. Most of my shoes are going to be these. I have a bunch of different photos throughout this video from Fits on Point, on Instagram. So that's kind of where I'm referencing a lot of these pictures. But with loud shoes, it's cool because you can wear more of a more chill outfit. You don't have to do anything crazy with the actual fit. You can let your shoes do the talking and then wear kind of more of casual or muted colors up top. So like you can wear a white tee, black pants, and a Jordan 1, and the Jordan 1's stealing the show. But it still looks great. It puts together a great aesthetic. Examples of loud shoes, of course, are the Jordan 1, the Nike SB Blazer, some the Nike Dunks come in a lot of different colorways. One shoe that I think is a little bit slept on in this category is Adidas Spezial. The Adidas Spezial, I think I'm gonna be giving a shot, but I think this is also a cool loud shoe from Adidas. Obviously, we're not only getting Nikes. I definitely rock with Adidas, so the Spezial is one there. There's really a lot of different shoes you can do in this category. This is definitely the shoe I own the most, the loud shoe. It really does a lot of talking, opposed to having, you know, different pieces on your body that are doing the talking. The shoe will do most of the talking for that outfit. Number three is the trainer. So the trainer I kind of categorize as comfort is key with the trainer. My example of the trainer is going to be, I have two actually. I have this Adidas in collaboration with St. Alfred. You know the boys over at St. Alfred, I mention almost every video. These shoes are what I would consider a trainer. You know, they do have a chunkier sole. They're almost like even considered a dad shoe. And I don't think they're really considered a dad shoe as much anymore. Honestly, this is just in trend now. It's not really something that's new. So it's accepted, not a dad shoe anymore. I'm gonna call it a trainer. It's super comfortable. It looks very cool. This is gonna be the best look for your casual wear. The second one I have, also have this Saucony Grid. This shoe is super available. I mean, it's relatively cheap as well. But I think it's a great choice as far as a trainer. Super comfortable. Really nice materials all over it. Other brands that do this really well are going to be like your Asics, your New Balance. They're kind of the kings of this space as far as the trainer goes. I would even consider Yeezys in the trainer category. I got the 500s on right now. Let's pop those bad boys off. Got the 500s on. Again, we have a real chunky sole, maximizing comfort, but it also looks good. It's very aesthetically pleasing as well. I think the trainer is where running meets lifestyle. You know, this isn't, you know, I'm not trying to give advice on what the best running shoe is, because I don't know. I don't really run, if you couldn't tell. It is a cool way to mix running and lifestyle because you're getting a lot of those comfort factors. You're getting a really thick sole with good cushioning, as well as making it look really good. So I think there's a ton of really nice trainers out today. You can definitely use the trainer in your everyday fits as well. This isn't something you have to only wear to the gym. This is a staple within my closet, within my rotation. I love having a good trainer, and I definitely utilize this in my everyday wear. Number four is going to be boots. So with boots, the key with boots is going to be that they can actually withstand all weather, all terrain. Like, they actually have to have a really solid functionality. You should be able to beat these up as well. I think that out of all of these shoes, I wear my shoes all the time, and I don't try to beat up shoes, but boots are something you should actively be able to beat up, and they should get better when they are beat up. I think with boots, the more subtle the colorway, the better. So when you're picking out a boot, if you kind of have a more muted, dull colorway, then let the rest of your fit speak for it. That's kind of how I think of boots. The boot I actually have to show off today is this is the Native Fitzsimmons. I don't know if they're still making these, but I'll link where you can buy them. This is a boot I got in, like, I wanna say 2016, 2017. I think it's a cool take on your rain boot or your all-weather boot. Obviously, Tim's are always an option. I've been steering a little bit more away from Tim's as of late. I don't think they look as good as far as where trends are going right now, but I think Tim's have always been a staple. I think some good options would be that you have the military boot, which is kind of like a Yeezy vibe. You can, of course, get a Yeezy boot. Doc Martens are fire, Duck boots. You can really do a lot of different things with the boot, and it's just a shoe you have to have in your rotation, especially if you live in Chicago, where I live. You have to have some kind of boot that can withstand everything. And right now it's straight up like -3 degrees outside and snowing like hell. So this is definitely a time a boot is necessary, but we still want to be able to get fits off in said boot. Number five is the casual shoe. So this is like, the casual shoe is like a true beater almost. Shoes that fit in this category would be like any kind of skate shoe. I would say a Vans Old School, a Converse, anything that's kind of got a flat sole and it's more chill. It's something you could wear every single day and it's not going to really throw off your outfit. With the casual shoe, you don't have to plan your outfit around the shoe. With a lot of the shoes I own, like, they're just they're wacky colorways. They're doing a lot. The casual shoe, you don't have to do that. It's a bit more chill, it's a bit more toned down, and you can really wear whatever with them. That doesn't mean that they're not fire. You can definitely put together fire fits. It's just your fit will be doing most of the talking and not the shoe. Some examples that I have here are, I've got a pair of Vans. I believe these are the Eras. This is a super casual shoe. I got it in the checkerboard colorway. Again, I can really wear whatever with this as far as the fit, and it's not gonna change anything. But it's just super easy to match and make anything work with that. Another one that I've got is going to be these Converse. So this is actually in collaboration with Wacko Maria. I hope I'm saying that right. This is the Converse Low. They did a high. I just thought these were sick because of the leopard print is pretty dope. It's something I've gotten into more recently. I think when it comes to buying Converse, I would highly recommend Converse within your rotation as this casual shoe. When it comes to Converse, one note is that you should always size at least a half size down. These are actually a 10.5, and I wear a 10.5, and I definitely should have gotten a 10. And then go for some of the different colorways. You don't have to do an all black. You don't have to do an all white. It's gonna add a little bit of flavor to your fit if you can add a little flavor to the shoe, add a colorway, or add a pattern like this one here. When I buy shoes, I look for things that are unique. I feel more confident when I have something that is not everyone has. That's what I do. That's how I like to dress myself. That's like how I like my fits to look. That's how I like my shoes. Try some new things, try some new patterns, some new colorways. I'm sure you'll at least figure out what you like. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Follow me on Instagram at babyboyflame. It's been your boy, Baby Boy Flame. I hope everyone has a good one and stay fresh out there.